Hello friends, welcome to TNPC audiobook book series. Attitude is Everything by Jeff Keller. Part 1. Success begins in the mind. Lesson 2. You are a human magnet. What is the key to success? Why do some people succeed while others fail? Earle Nightingale, the great success writer, broadcaster and speaker, addressed this issue in his famous recorded message entitled The Strangest Secret. In this program, he identified the key to success in just 6 words. Of course, he went on to explain it in more detail, but the foundation of his success secret is only 6 words. You would like to know the 6 words, wouldn't you? Well, before I tell you this key to success, you might be surprised to learn that the same 6 words are also the key to failure. Are you ready for the key to success? Here it is. We become what we think about. On a gut level, does it make sense to you? In this research on the subject, Nightingale found that all of the great writers, philosophers and religious leaders have agreed that our thoughts determine our action. Here are the observations of a few great thinkers on this very point. Napoleon Hill said, "What is the mind can convince and believe the mind can achieve." The Bible contains numerous references to thinking, including these: "According to your faith, be it unto you. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. If you can believe, all things are possible." Ralph Waldo Emerson put it this way: "A man is what he thinks about all day long." Robert Collier offered this insist: "There is nothing on earth you cannot have, once you have mentally accepted the fact that you can have it." And finally, there are the well-known words of Henry Ford, who said, "Whether you think you can or think you can't, you are right." Subtitle: How this principle works. Let's examine this concept a little further, that we become what we think about. Here is how it works. If you constantly think about a particular goal, then you will take steps to move forward that goal. Let's say that someone who we would call Fred thinks he is capable of earning $30,000 per year. Like a human magnet, Fred will attract those employment opportunities that will move him in that direction. As long as Fred clings to that thought, he will reach his goal of earning $30,000 per year. Now, what if Fred begins to think, "Hey, I would like to earn more money to meet the growing needs of my family. I want to earn $50,000. Will Fred's income increase? It depends. Just how strong is Fred's belief that he can earn $50,000? It's quite possible that Fred would like to earn $50,000, but he doesn't believe that he is really capable of earning that amount. In that case, Fred will not reach his income goal of $50,000. If, on the other hand, Fred continuously thinks about earning the higher income and believe in his ability to achieve that goal, he will, in fact, increase his income to $50,000. As you might expect, this concept is not limited to monetary goals. Suppose you're shooting a round of 95 on a golf course right now. By concentrating on bringing that score down to 85 and by truly believing in your ability to do so, you will begin to take steps to move towards that goal. You may take lesson, you may practice more, but in the end, you will bring your score down and reach your objective. Subtopic: Dominant thoughts rule the way. The idea that we become what we think about has also been expressed as the law of dominant thought. This means that there is a power within each of us that propels us in the direction of our current dominant thoughts. The key word here is dominant. You can't expect positive results when you spend 10 seconds a day thinking positively and the remaining 16 waking hours dwelling on negative outcomes. Here is the bottom line. A little positive thinking doesn't produce positive result, just like a little bit of a diet doesn't work. It's like trying to lose weight by eating a healthy, low-calorie breakfast and then picking out on cake and ice cream for the rest of the day. The same is true of exercise. You can't do a few minutes of exercise once a week and expect to be physically fit. Look at positive thinking in the same way. A little bit just doesn't get the job done. Instead, you must take control of your mental activity and think positively throughout each and every day until it becomes a habit. Remember, it has to be your dominant thought pattern. Take a moment to consider your dominant thought in the major area of your life. Are they serving you or holding you back? Subtitle: Attitude adjustment leads to real estate ownership. Let me share a personal example to demonstrate the power of our thoughts. In the 1980s and early 1970s, I observed many people in my area, Long Island, New York, who were making a lot of money by purchasing homes for investment purposes and renting them out. The homes were appreciating in value considerably each year. Sure, there was the usual headaches of having to deal with tenant problems, but the return these investors were getting was incredible. Well, I kept thinking that I should start buying some investment homes, but I never took any action because I continued to doubt myself. My thinking was dominated by all of the things that could go wrong. Simply put, I had a lousy attitude, and with the negative attitude, is it any wonder that I never took the first step? However, after I started reading books and listening to tapes on the power of attitude and belief, I decided to change my attitude about real estate investment. In the summer of 1986, I decided that before the end of that year, I would purchase two investment houses. This time, I wasn't going to allow any negative thoughts to creep into my mind. For 6 months, I focused my thinking on one thing, owning two investment homes. I wrote down my goals several times each day and referred to them often. I believed at the deepest level of my being that I would own two homes before the end of the year. In the evening and on weekends, I went with the real estate agents to look at homes. I personally visited about 100 homes and researched hundreds of others. In the fall of 1986, I purchased an investment property. What a great feeling of accomplishment to do something that I wouldn't allow myself to do before. But I still had work to do. And on December 29, just 2 days before the end of the year, I reached my goal and bought the second investment home. As I look back at why I was able to purchase the real estate in 1986, well, I couldn't do it in the year before that. The answer is clear. In 1986, I believed that I could do it. I had an unshakable positive attitude that propelled me forward to reach my goal. This entire experience was tremendously valuable to me. In fact, it was priceless because it taught me that you can achieve your goal when you believe in yourself and you keep your thoughts focused on the positive. Subtopic: Attitude versus action. I have been talking a lot about thinking, and you might be wondering where action fits into this process. It's true that you don't get results without action, but recognize that thoughts precede action. I always knew the action that I would have to take to buy those investment properties, contract realtors, visit properties, review newspaper listening, and so on. But I never took the first step as long as I had a negative attitude. The instant I changed my attitude, I felt compelled to take action and nothing was going to stop me. That's why a positive belief system is the starting point for the achievement of any goal. When your dominant belief is that you can achieve your goal, you begin taking the action necessary to move in that direction. Submitting: Your circumstance reflect what you have been thinking about. Face this fact. Your belief brought you to where you are today, and your thinking from this point forward will take you to where you will be in the future. In fact, your result in every area of your life reflect your deeply held thoughts about yourself. Consider your finances. What are your beliefs in this area? Are you constantly thinking about not having enough money? Dwell on that thought. A lack of fund and you block the flow of money to you. And then there's a matter of relationship. If you think that you don't deserve much, you attract friends and partners into your life who won't treat you very well. I will bet you know someone who always seems to go out with the wrong person. In fact, the last 29 people they have got out with were wrong for them. Do you think this is a merry coincidence or no? There is a deeply held belief inside this individual that attracts these people into his or her life. And whether we are talking about finances, relationship or career, the fact remains, if your thought don't change, your result won't change. Subtopic, change your thinking. Fortunately, there's existing news. You can change your thoughts thereby changing your results. Here is how. For starters, become aware of what you say to yourself all day. Each of us has an internal voice. In other words, we talk to ourselves. Too often, however, what we say is negative, critical, and self-limiting. Perhaps you find yourself thinking, I can't do this, or I always mess things up. This thought works against you. Instead, repeat to yourself that you can and will accomplish your goal. As we will discuss more fully in part 2 of this book, it's also important to become aware of the words you use on a regular basis. For example, do you put yourself down or talk about the things you could never have or achieve? Your mind, heart, hears every word you speak, and like a magnet, you will ultimately attract the events and circumstances that correspond to your dominant belief. So, make sure to use positive words about yourself and your goal. Subtopic, repetition is the key. Here are two more action steps to help you become more positive and get the results you want. Step 1. Every day, read some positive, uplifting literature. Find 15 to 30 minutes in the morning to do this. And it's also a good idea to do some reading right before bed. There's literally thousands of motivational books and articles to choose from. Read whatever speaks to you. It could be the Bible or other spiritual material, or perhaps inspiring biographies. You will find a wide selection of success books in the psychology and self-improvement section of any bookstores or library. So check them out. Step 2. Every day, listen to motivational audio programs. You can listen to them in your car while commuting, at home, or during your exercise routine. The key is repetition. When you hear this message over and over, they become part of you, and you begin to implement them to improve your life. This will get you thinking about your attitude and other success principles on a daily basis. Of course, audio programs are not a substitute from action. It's up to you to put these ideas to work. So, if you read something positive and listen to motivational audio programs every day, it will make a phenomenal difference in your life. I can tell you from personal experience that these techniques work if you have the discipline to stick with them. The lesson I have learned in this, change your thinking and you change your life. You will become what you think about. Subtopic, don't count on overnight success. Before concluding, I would like to clarify a few things about positive thinking and the power of our thoughts. First of all, positive thinking doesn't mean that you will achieve your goal overnight. It's not as if you start thinking about making more money and the next morning you woke up and find a stack of dollar bills at your bedside. Not by a long shot. Success requires effort, commitments, and patience. And secondly, positive thinking doesn't mean you won't have any more problems. Believe me, you will have plenty of setbacks along the way. However, if you continue to believe in yourself, take action and persist, you will overcome those obstacles. Remember, you are constantly moving in the direction of your dominant thought. Everything you achieve in your lifetime flows from your thoughts and beliefs. Negative thinking yield negative result and positive thinking produce positive result. Keep your attitude window clean and bring so that bright so that the positive thoughts can come shining through. It simply makes no sense to think negative thoughts unless you want to get negative result. And I know you don't want that to happen. So from this point forward, choose your thoughts wisely and use this powerful principle to get fantastic result in your life. Thank you friends for listening to TNPC audiobook. Please do support and subscribe our channel for more audiobooks. Also, don't forget to press the bell button.